Hello, lovelies. Today we are going to be talking about White is for Witching by Helen Oyeyemi. I sincerely hope I am pronouncing that right. This is one of the weirdest contemporary fantasy horror books that I've ever read. Before we get started, remember to click that subscribe button and ring the bell so you don't miss another video. I post new videos on Sunday. You can also find me on Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook. All the links are in the description. The birthday giveaway is still going on. 5 subscribers will receive a signed copy of Homestead Hunts, an illustrated science fiction novella. Subscribe to this channel for a chance to win. On to the review. So, White is for Witching is about this girl named Miranda. Her life becomes very weird and haunted after her mom dies. She develops an eating disorder, but not one that's typically well known. It's called pica, where people eat things that aren't food. In her case, she develops an addiction to eating chalk and plastic. She also starts hearing and seeing things that may or may not be ghosts. Like, she sees a perfect version of herself kind of following her around everywhere she goes. And it's, like, I call her Creepy Miranda because she just kind of appears and disappears at will. She's, like, never says anything, but she's got, like, this creepy smile and sharp, pointy teeth and just is not something that I would ever want to come across in a dark alley. Also, the house itself is alive, sentient, and hostile to outsiders, especially people of color. Basically, weird magic girl lives in a racist house. This book does not have a whole lot of characters. There's Miranda, our main character. She starts off the story a high school girl and goes on to college. She's got a twin brother named Elijah. They've got a dad who runs the bed and breakfast. Ore, who is Miranda's black fellow student and eventual girlfriend. The house itself. Their mom, who is dead, and a couple of other characters. We need to talk about some triggers in this story. Obviously, there's the eating disorder. Miranda also develops a lot of insomnia, so there's that. There's mental health issues, cultural self-harm, racism, anti-immigration, and implied incest. So I've mentioned that this is a fantasy novel, contemporary fantasy. They're hanging around in the UK. The magic here is never fully explained. It's a very, very, very soft magic system. There are a lot of things that are implied but not outright spoken, and this is true for the entire family. It's not just the magic here. And there are some genuinely creepy moments. One of my favorite scenes in the novel is after Ori and Miranda start dating, Ori visits the house, remember the sentient, racist house, to meet the family, introduce herself, normal, typical dating stuff. During her visit, Ori takes a shower and is toweling herself off with a white towel. And everywhere that the towel touches her skin, it stains black. So it's just little creepy things like that that start off kind of slow in the start of the book and then gradually accumulate more and more until the very end. And there's more than one point where I'm just like, oh god, that's just not right. So yeah, there's that. That's the book, really. That's the entire book. I mentioned that it starts off kind of slow. It is very slow, really. The first half kind of drags a little bit in some parts, and then something really weird, creepy, or engaging will just come out of nowhere, and I'll be like, what the heck just happened? But because the soft magic system is never explained, I never really do know what happened. But it's enough to keep me going and keep reading. There are a lot of point of view switches here. Most of the book is told from first person point of view from one of 3 viewpoints. Elijah, Ore, or the house itself. Occasionally, it swoops on over to third-person point of view when it has to focus on Miranda when she's outside of one of those 3 spheres. Obviously, this can get a little confusing at times, especially in the beginning where you're just like, okay, I thought that this was Elijah's point of view, but actually this whole section is Ore's point of view. She never tells you when she's switching POVs or who it is that's talking. You kind of have to figure it out for yourself. I will say that it has the desired effect, which is a very dreamlike, ethereal reading experience where you're not entirely sure what's going on, whether or not you can trust the person who's talking to you, things like that. So it's a very unique read. Normally I would go into like what the plot is about or what the story is. There really kind of isn't one. I mean, obviously there is a story. Like the first half is introducing us to this family, Miranda and Elijah finding out that their mom is dead and kind of coping with that. And then in the second half, Miranda goes to college and properly meets and starts dating Ori. But there's no real... It's not like most fantasy stories where the characters are like, we have to do X, Y, and Z in order to do A, B, C. There's none of that. It's just very kind of slice of life, almost. If life involved creepy other Miranda people and mannequins that can just suddenly become alive and walk around the house and racist sentient houses. This story is very engaging, but it's not one of my favorites. I think it's just too weird for me personally. I prefer more obvious, in-your-face magic and harder, better explained magic systems. It could just be that this book is too smart for me. I don't know. I'm giving it 3 stars. I would recommend this book for anyone who is looking for something new, anyone who particularly likes dark fantasy or horror even, and people who like racism addressed in their books. This book does talk a lot about racism and anti-immigration. Also, recently with everything that's happened with the Black Lives Matter movement and protests, a lot of people have been looking for books by Black authors and authors of color to read. Helen Oyeyemi, you can see, does fit the bill. And she does talk a lot about racial issues and anti-immigration in this book. So if that's something that you're interested in, something that you want to support Black authors, I do recommend this book. I probably won't read it again myself personally, but I don't regret reading it. That's it for today. If you liked this video, hit subscribe so you don't miss another. My birthday giveaway is still going on. I will be giving away signed copies of Homestead Hunt's illustrated sci-fi novella, part of the Earth's Final Chapter series. Winners will be announced in early September. Also, let me know if you've read White is for Witching and what you thought of it, and if you have any book recommendations for myself and the community. Bye, lovelies!